everybody.
New lifeboat to the town. Here she comes, arriving on shore for the very first time in the history of this new boat. Proud moment for the RNLI here in town. There's no proud moment for the town. A proud moment for the crew actually inside the boat. An amazing moment in there in life to be on this boat to come ashore for the first time. The RNLI 1318 driving home in the Queen of the Welsh Seaside Resorts. Here she comes. The captain and the crew who sailed her for 400 miles home from Poole in Dorset, the man that knows the Queen, which it is, of the Welsh Seaside Resort. We have just witnessed a moment in RNLI history, and this is the first ever Shannon class lifeboat to be in service on the Welsh coastline.
So the slide unit has been pushed out the boat, and Scott will be passed over the bow of the boat by the crew, and attached to which on the slide, from where the boat will be hauled up onto the river. The head launcher in the orange hat there, all the signals to the tractor driver, the flying operator, as I say, are by hand. So this is taking the training that's been ongoing in this session. We've seen a whole bunch of training coming together for the first time today.
A 360-degree turn.
Yes, that's the lifeboat up onto the carriage, which will be rotated through the different routes, and so it's ready to go to the boundaries. We're on board the boat with the passenger crew. We have the opportunity of a decent night's sleep ourselves, because the boat is now moving somewhere, and there's been some minimum time around the world. Graham Heritage on the stern of the boat there with a sunroof. Lifeboat intends to be something running in family.
Certainly running in Graham family.
Indeed, Greg's father and Corin, Dennis is the captain of the previous lifeboat. So, you know, we've got a lot of heritage today.
Proud family moments. Just a few.
Thank you.
smiles at the moment.
I think Mr. Blanchie, he's the station's truck driver. Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Now the boats come round, you can see the water jets and people up on the road here at the back, and that's the propeller boat. So you can see there's two tubes that the water blasts out of. It gives about the thrust and also its directional capability. And the two black sort of semicircular things are what are known as the buckets, and those come over the jets to give us the power, very similar to the way an aircraft slows down on a runway.
So the fire is the slides in it, acts sing it on the same principle as if you would sing as a Hollyhead rifle being launched down the road. That's the same sort of principle, but it tilts.
Yeah, so Royal Blue is the slip rate boats, which is safe to deep water, so they can launch there all the time, their slip rate. Here, there's nowhere where you can have that consistency to be able to have a slip rate boat and take a slip rate to the water. Just now putting the boat into its final position on the carry.
It must also, Robin, be very pleasing for the mounted crew and the store crew and to see so many people turn out this morning to welcome the Leonettes.
Yeah, it's very touching to see so many sort of friendly faces and the members of the public here today to support the work of London, no RNLI. Without the support of the public, of course, there would be no RNLI because it depends solely on protection and contribution.
Now this next bit's all off the cuff because I've just looked in the audience here. It's slightly white because it's the Mayor of Pembina who's here.
Ah, sorry, you're here, yeah.
The Mayoress as well.
Yes.
The Mayor and Mayoress have joined us, ladies and gentlemen. I didn't know, you didn't have your chains, obviously, so Sonia and Francis, welcome to you. Would you like to say a few words, Mr. Mayor, on behalf of the Town Council, because this is an amazingly historic day for the town?
Yeah, it's a wonderful occasion for the town to have not only a new lifeboat, but a new lifeboat station, because we've been in the old one for quite a while. And as Robin was saying before, it didn't serve the purpose of this wonderful new boat. And to see so many people here. I have just come from another trailer show, and sorry I'm late. But the achievement we have spent on done, bringing the boat back all that way, is incredible. And oh my God, I'm going to go a little bit. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Well done. And thank you to everybody else for coming here today and supporting the RNLI. It's a wonderful tour. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. So many few words on behalf of the Pembina Town Council. Thank you very much for joining us. I just spotted you there. I didn't want to miss the moment of you being here then. So. Absolutely, yes. Look, it's great that you're here. Bear in mind, ladies and gentlemen, to stay behind the takeoff areas, the flagged off areas. Please don't venture anywhere inside the cordoned off area at any time during today's proceedings, please. We want to make sure that everybody's kept safe. If you've got any dons with you at all, please keep your dons on the lead under control just whilst we're doing everything that needs to be done.
Another advantage to boats through this system is that once the boat hits the beach, the crew will stay on board the boat until the boat is finally housed in the boathouse. Whereas in the old system where recovery was carried in very labour intensive, you could be at sea for a number of hours in the ride back of the slipway, cold and exhausted. But the first thing you know is if you get off the boat and then start pulling sticks around you. And recovering the boat, which would be very exciting after an arduous service. So for the boat's crew, it's a great opportunity.
So what's the situation regarding children drinking on board? I mean, if you go out of the shack, your pace goes off, you have no idea what situation you're going to be faced with. I'll bring to your attention what happened in Pandora's a few years ago. Must be at sea for hours and then you're still being really green. Are the salmon on the water today? Have any of you seen them? What is it?
What is it? We've got obviously tea and coffee and hot water and the like. Sweets, we like
sweets
that.
As well.
We like that chocolate.
Wow.
And also on board are what we call pap pans. So the self-eating pans with the food such as Irish stew, beans and sausages. Yeah, beef stew here as well. Very nice.
Sunderland?
Yeah, marvellous. Yeah, so we do get looked at.
Right, see. Well, there's Les waving. Welcome home, Les. How long has Les been with you in the line now?
Yes, I think Les has been with us perhaps 30, 73 at the moment. And what you've just heard now is the page is going off. It's the Coast Guard actually contacting the launching authority. You can see there, Alan, with the radio in his hand.
So this is not a training?
No, this is real. We don't know what it is yet. So we'll just have to see what's happening.
So what happens now, Robin? The page has gone off. We've seen the lads running off there to see what's going on.
Yeah.
What would happen, what's going to happen now then? How does the system work? This is real.
Yeah, what happens is Holyhead Coast Guard will page what people know as the launching authority. Who will have a pager who will then contact the Coast Guard.
So this is Marcus and Paul?
Yeah, Marcus, Paul, Mike, Alan, whoever the duty launching authority is. Yeah. And then they will have a discussion with the Coast Guard about the nature of the problem. And make a decision, first and ready to launch the lifeboat, which lifeboat to launch and where to launch it. So those discussions will be going on now. Most of the ships are stationed at the inshore lifeboat, so that's why the inshore lifeboat people you can see the crew there are starting to ready themselves, because the lifeboat is transported to wherever it needs to be transported to. So that could be the west shore, and far away from the bay. So there'll be discussions going on right now. We can see Paul Morton, he's on the phone. We're discussing what's necessary.
So everything with the WMFX is on hold.
Yeah.
They will keep it there, just in case the all-weather has to go out.
Well, the station all-weather lifeboat is the Mersey lifeboat. You can see out there on the mooring. So should it be an all-weather lifeboat job, which the crew will transport out there by the ILB, and then it's an ILB job, obviously the ILB will be transported to wherever it's.
So this is one reason why there's two members on the Andy Pierce who will be ready everything.
Whilst
the crew have been taken, that's the reason why they're out there.
Yeah, that's right, and also to keep an eye that if it goes on to drag the mooring or something like that. So, it's been cancelled. So I don't quite know what's happened, I'm sure somebody will tell us. Paul, can you come over and tell us what's just gone on with the pages and the like?
You can use my microphone, Paul, over here. We're over here. We're over here.
We'll be manning you.
Come to you, Paul.
Yeah,
Holly Henry
just got a call from So there you go, it's nice to see Paul here, because the launching authorities are often the people who are the unsung heroes, the people who make the decision to know whether the boat goes or not. So thanks for that, Paul.
Thank you, Paul. Now, just been looking in the audience, so we've got Dr. Green with us. Have you got a moment, Jen? Ladies and gentlemen, can we have a round of applause for the, I suppose, the doctor for the kind of RNLI, Dr. J.J. Green, Dr. John Green. John, welcome to you. This is obviously a very special historic day. As the doctor for the organ, how are you feeling at this moment in time on this day?
Well, very proud and very emotional.
seamless boat in two halves, and the all-weather lifeboat when she was built. And then Rachel saw her on the hard side, so she was able to do. Then saw her also come through in the pool, and the kind of what it's like to remember the first of the family.
Now, for everybody who doesn't know Dr. Green, I think most people in this town know JJ. He's known as JJ, and you will see him pounding the streets for many, many years. He's wearing his blue shorts, he's got his headband on, and his RMLI running vest. He puts his head down and he just goes for it. You've raised a lot of money over the years, JJ, for the RMLI, by running marathons. And I think you've just done three. How many marathons have you run to help support the service? I don't embarrass you, I'm not trying to do that, but I mean, the dedication from people, the volunteers, and the practitioner for the RMLI. How many marathons today?
Well, 61 marathons,
ladies and gentlemen, for the RMLI. I think that deserves a round of applause. Goodness gracious, JJ.
My last volunteer to my runners today, the Birmingham, which was on the 15th of October, followed by the Dublin Marathon, which was on the 29th of October, and by the return to New York, the only capital on the 5th of November, that's about 64.
But of course, you couldn't do what you do without the support of all your patients. You've always got the phones up in the surgery here in Craigadon. You have great support from the people of Llandudno, your patients.
I certainly do. I won't tell you which drawer in my desk is full of money, but most consultations end with a transfer of a donation. Even if there isn't a marathon poster up on the wall, it was still very kind. And I've also been have a great support from most organisations, like the IAOB and the Lions, the Dragon Lions, and the Colin Bay Lions as well. With all of the great things before, it's very good to charge.
I've been following the progress of the Women of Kids through your Facebook page, because you've been down to four several times. You've got some great photos of the build of the Women of Kids. As the GP for the RMLI, how many years have you been in that role here in Llandudno?
I actually joined the station about 6 weeks after the ambulance arrived, about 25 months after the station. I'm also the regional expert by the company.
So it's a bad day for you, bad day for everybody today.
Very much so. It's a part of everybody. And of course, everyone's got to play at least a vision that's going to be lost.
Dr. JJ Green, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for JJ. I'm sponsoring for all these marathons, you see. You know, it's tough to remark that it's on 61. Oh my goodness. He just goes for his head down, he just goes for his abs and all that. Goodness gracious. Yeah. lifeboat that you are here today to witness all this moment in history.
The boat's out to the water, that's not the end of it by any means. There's the initial hosing down now, because at sea water, which you're probably aware, is massively corrosive, so it's really important to get any remnants of their seawater off the equipment. And then there'll be probably a couple of days of lubrication and cleaning at the same by the mechanic and the crew under normal circumstances, whereas this boat, you know, it's going to be very active over the next eight to nine days. So again, it's part of the teamwork of the RNLI. Not everybody can be on the boat's crew. So the shore crew are of equal importance and are considered of equal value and merit on the station.